This is the Chevalier. It's doing awesome. You got these nice big seat heads, super tall. It's coming up to my chest here. This is the Maris Otter, not doing as well. It's just coming up now, in fact. And I believe this is because it's a winter variety, so it does a lot better in cooler temperatures. And we had a really hot spell in the spring for about a week. It was unusually warm, and it seemed to really affect the growth. So, but it is coming up. That's good to see. Looks like the heads are going to be a little bit small, though. Okay, so here's the bare barley. Most of it is ready. And I should have plenty of seed in there to do a much bigger plot this next year. Here's my owl, which seems to really be helping. I haven't seen any squirrels or mice in here so far. I see a lot of weeds though, a lot of vetch. This stuff here is vetch. You don't want that to go to seed. You can see the seed pods on it. Once that's in your garden, it spreads like crazy. I've got it everywhere. I'm actually quite impressed by the size of these. So just picking the last of the Chevalier, and I didn't have any taken from by rats or mice or squirrels or anything, so it's gonna be a good crop this year. Walk over to here, you can see the Maris Otter is just being overrun with weeds. The problem is, at this stage, if you pick the weeds, you just might pick some of the barley with it. It's hard to even see the barley in there. Okay, it's August 6th, and I've just started to harvest the Maris Otter. There's quite a bit of it that's still green, so I'm just sort of selectively picking out the dry ones. As you can see, it's pretty hard though, with so many weeds in there and all that clover and vetch. Working on the compost pile. It's getting pretty big. Gonna want it to be about twice this size though. That'd be nice. And over here, got some coriander I'm gonna take home. Some of it's dry enough to harvest, so I'm gonna put that in a wheat beer. Alright, it's September 2nd and I'm finally getting the very last of the Maris Otter. Just got this 1.5 beds to go through. Most of it's already harvested, I'm just getting the last few stragglers. So basically what I'm doing is just grabbing a whole handful like that and just picking off what I can find there. Quite a few on that one, but if you look at the rest of it, it's mostly weeds. It's been so slow this year to harvest this stuff because of the weeds and the inconsistent rate at which it grew. I mean, there's still some green ones in here, which I'm just gonna have to chuck. I'm trying to get all of it just so I don't get any rats. And I'm just throwing all the straw onto the compost pile over here. And that is it. Here is the last of it. I'll take that home and dry it out. Okay, my total is 16 pounds and 1 ounce of the Chevalier. And I've just reserved in the bag there 2 pounds for seed. And I've got 9 pounds and 11 ounces of the Maris Otter.
And in that little bag, I've got 2 1/4 pounds of the bear barley. So the grand total comes out to 28 pounds altogether, which is not that great. It's not bad. That's for a plot that was 20 feet by 25 feet. So that's 500 square feet, although there were paths in between the beds. So that reduces the square footage there. So 28 pounds for 500 square feet. I'd expect a little more next year, just because I had such a bad crop of the Maris Otter. They're basically on the same size for square footage. Actually, the Chevalier took up less square footage than the Maris Otter. So that's why I've decided to not grow the Maris Otter anymore. I am just going to stick to the Chevalier. It just really outperformed on all fronts, basically for speed, for size, and for uniformity, consistency. It all seemed to ripen at the same time. So I'm going to stick to that next year, and I'm also going to plant a little bit of the bear because I want to brew with that, so I'm just curious about that one.